Houston Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, your weekly look at what's happening on board the International Space Station. I'm Nicole Cloutier-Lemasters. This week kicked off with a vehicle leaving the station. The Russian Progress 53 cargo ship undocked for the final time on Monday. It delivered about 3 tons of food, fuel, and supplies to the station back in November and tested some new automated docking equipment during a maneuver in April. It burned up in the Earth's atmosphere just a few hours after undocking. The crew spent some time this week working on checkouts of a new U.S. spacesuit on board. Alexander Gurr sized the new extravehicular mobility unit, known as EMU-3003, for future use by Station Commander Steve Swanson. The suit is undergoing its certification for upcoming spacewalks out of the U.S. Quest airlock, planned for later this summer. And they say you reap what you sow. Well, that applies in space too. We've told you about the station's veggie facility, a chamber used for plant growth in space. This week, Steve Swanson harvested a crop of 6 red romaine lettuce plants that were grown from seed in the chamber. Swanson packed the plants into the onboard freezer, and they'll be returned to Earth so the scientists can analyze the plants and determine if they'll be a viable food option for future missions. In this week's Twitter question, Kellen asks, "What does space smell like?" Well, quite a few astronauts have commented on the subject, and they confirm space definitely has a distinct smell. Many describe it as smelling like hot metal. The astronauts can get a whiff right after a spacewalk when hydrocarbon molecules cling to their spacesuits, or right after a vehicle docks to the station. Make sure to keep sending your questions and comments using the hashtag #SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.